So let's see what you guys got coming in new for love this month of June. I feel like someone's not seeing a key to a door that's right there in front of them. The key is right there, but somebody is sad about something, or they're still trying to heal from some kind of loss of some sort, maybe. But they're not seeing that there's a key right there that's gonna fit right in that hole. So there's something new that's coming for you guys, and it could possibly be a twin flame, your Two of Cups. I feel like a lot of you are gonna be coming into a new relationship. There's gonna be something different about this person from you. Or you're not seeing this new start just yet. It might take you a while to pick your head up and realize that key is right there, that Two of Cups is right around the corner. Some of you may feel stuck in something before you come to this Two of Cups, or as you come into this Two of Cups, like you might meet someone new, but you feel stuck for some reason and you're not seeing that the key is right there. Make sure you're communicating clearly and seeing things clearly. So don't rush into anything. Make sure you're really getting the information you need. Make sure you're really seeing things for what it is. Or you are definitely taking the precautionary steps as you start to meet this person. You slowly get to know them. You're not rushing into anything. Like, you're just enjoying the beginning. Like, you're definitely not rushing anything. You're not looking for anything. You're just trying to meet new people, possibly. Trying to get new connections. Not always in just love. I think a lot of you are searching for actual friends to be able to hang out with. You're working. You're definitely working on seeing things from a different perspective. I feel like some of you might have, like I said, have been through some stuff in your past, and that this is keeping you a little stuck at the moment, but you are working towards getting yourself out there more, really trying to make the connections that you think are worth your time. You might be very busy, but you're willing to meet someone in the middle if they are meant to be in your life. I feel like a lot of you are no longer putting work into connections that are not worth your time.
I have Pessy.
Shh, I'm recording. No. Mm-hmm. You definitely are realizing that not every connection is worth your time, so you're definitely working and putting in the effort where it's needed and no longer putting effort into dead ends. Yeah, you're definitely not running towards things that are not running towards you. Oh my goodness. That's when I feel like a lot of you, when you come out of this sorrow, this feeling at a loss of something, that's when you're gonna come into your match, and you're definitely working on your emotional side. I feel like a lot of you are a very emotional people, and you're working on this. You're no longer putting all your emotions into one cup until this connection or cup is also filling up your cup. Like, you definitely want an even playing field. So now you know, like, you've been through all this ish, but it was a good thing. Like, it showed you what you needed to know, and it gives you that strength now to realize that not every connection is worth your time, and that you realize that you are looking for someone to put in the same type of effort that you're putting into. You want someone to pour into your cup as well. Like, you want even balance, even give and take. You're no longer up. I feel like some of you are like, normally you got your head up in the clouds and you're always thinking about love and you always think with your heart, which is not a bad thing. But you're changing this because you're no longer gonna wear your heart on your sleeve, so to speak. Like, you're now putting a bubble around yourself and not just letting anybody in. Like, you're doing the work that you need to do, and you're no longer walking on this thin little rope. You're now walking on a whole fresh new start. Like, I feel like a lot of you definitely coming out of some ish, and you're realizing, and you're taking those rose colored glasses off and getting your head out of the clouds, and really working on yourself and really putting your boundaries up. Like, a lot of you had to work on some boundaries in order for you to actually come into the match your emperor or empress. You had to stable out your own emotions. You definitely had to do some healing. And when you do this healing and you're actually filling up your own cup, that's when this ship comes in. When you stop chasing things for that are not chasing you. And I feel like a lot of you came out of this, like you came out of feeling stuck and you took that blindfold off and realized you were keeping yourself stuck. A lot of you did some thinking before you did this walking away from a cup. Some of you might have walked away from another situation, and now you're just doing you and you're working on yourself when your person comes in. I definitely feel like a lot of you are really going within. Like, you're keeping to yourself more now. You're not really hanging out with very many, and you're just really in your truth. Like, I really think a lot of you are finding yourselves at this point in your life, and you're walking away from things that are not tangible anymore. Yeah, you're definitely holding on to your pentacles before you just hand it off to just anybody. You want something that's nurturing, somebody that feels like home, someone that feels warm. Like, you can grow with them and you're not having to feel like you're always in that flight or flight mode with them. So you might have had some really big ish going on in other relationships that really made you who you are today. Like, you definitely grew from all of the stuff that happened to in your past, and you don't regret any of it. I feel like a lot of you realize you needed this stuff in your past in order to grow and move forward in your life and be able to come into your power now, because it showed you what you needed and it gave you that strength within. And I feel like a lot of you are like reinventing yourselves as well. Starting new jobs, starting, maybe some of you are going back to school, working on your pentacle. Like, you're definitely getting that pentacle and you're no longer just giving it to anybody. So some of you might have been giving your money away to other people, and now you're realizing not just anybody is worth giving all that hard earned money to just anyone. Like, you're walking away from being so giving. Like, it's not a bad thing to be giving, but when you're overcompensating and you're making yourself less than, like, you're to the point where you have empty pockets is what I heard. Like, you're realizing that you don't need to empty your pockets in order to be a giving person. I also feel like a lot of you are going to be coming into some money as well, because of all this good you've done, all these good deeds. Now you're going to get that karma coming back to you. You're manifesting this into your life because of all the good things you've done in your past, all the times that you have given to others and helped them. This is manifesting into your life now, and this karma is starting to come out. Like, you've paid up so much karmic debt, and you've, like, I feel like a lot of you really stacked up that karma, the good karma, because of all the stuff you kept doing, all being so caring, so giving, so loving. I feel like a lot of you are definitely coming into something. A lot of you, I hear you played your cards right. Yeah, you're definitely getting your Ten of Cups. Like, you're realizing